WideCells Group has told investors the stem cells services provider's ideally positioned to start generating revenues in 2017 from all of its three divisions, as they announced this morning in their 2016 full-year results. Chief Executive Joao Andrade is with me now on Skype. Joao, good morning to you. Good to see you.
Hi, good morning, Andrew, and thank you for having me today.
Joao, you listed back in July last year. How would you describe the progress you've made since then?
The first thing is we are completely in line with the expectations that we described in our prospectus during the IPO process. Perhaps we have some things that we've managed to do ahead of schedule, and also some new opportunities that we have tapped into, and some key appointments to our board as well that have helped to increase perhaps the company value and our position as well.
What's the latest with CellPlan? You're looking to launch that pretty soon in the UK, aren't you?
Yeah, so we've been finalizing our e-commerce platform, where we will be able to inform patients and expecting parents about the benefits of stem cell treatments and storing stem cells. But in the platform, we will be able to receive the applicant details for our insurance plan. We'll be able to conduct a health questionnaire, collect payments, and issue the insurance policy digitally as well. So that's something we have developed. And the last steps now before launching the product is just to refine the marketing approach with our partner, which is BioVault, a corporate bank in the UK, one of the most accredited corporate banks in the world. And we are just about to start sales from CellPlan.
You've been quite impressed, haven't you, with the interest there's been in CellPlan?
Yes, we have, because we've not only we've signed the first agreement with BioVault in the UK, we've started to sign letters of intent also with corporate banks in Brazil, and we've received contacts from corporate banks from all continents. And at the moment, we are conducting quality assessments, the quality assessment for these corporate banks to see which ones we can work with first, and put that into our strategic plan and start rolling out CellPlan in other markets and other corporate banks during the course of the year. So we'll keep the market updated on our progress as well.
Very good, Joe. Look, what's the latest with your stem cell processing and storage facility up in Manchester here?
Well, we received very good news this month in March, because we were doing upgrading work to get the facility up and running now in Q2 this year. And one of the key steps was to receive the validation for our clean rooms. And we have received that this month. The last stage we are going through now is what's called process validation, which is pretty much processing and storing the first stem cells to show the results to the Human Tissue Authority. We should be doing that sometime in April. And following that, we have a couple of weeks to receive final confirmation from the Human Tissue Authority. And we are expecting to have the lab operational in May, which will allow us to start research and also to start processing and storing stem cells for expecting parents in the UK.
Certainly significant for you at WideCells. Look, Joao, I want to talk about Wide Academy. Post-period end, of course, you appointed the former head of Apple as a non-exec director and VP. You told me you felt very fortunate to have him on board. That's exciting for Wide Academy.
Yes, it is, because something I keep mentioning, the stem cell technology has been around for more than 40 years. There are treatments available with life-saving potential. There are a lot of innovation in the new treatments becoming available using umbilical cord blood stem cells. But it's our responsibility and our mission to get this message to the healthcare community globally, and also to potential clients that are now looking to store their baby stem cells, and also patients that are looking for a solution. And with that in mind, I really wanted the best person in the world, the best person in terms of positioning within the ed tech space, someone with the profile of Alan, who's been director for Apple Education in Europe and Asia, to help us to take advantage of the digital marketing tools that are available today for us to have curated content on stem cell technology being disseminated in the right channels with the potential to reach hundreds of thousands of, if not millions of people all over the world. So just as an interesting point, Alan, one of the podcasts that he built when he was at Apple has hit 3 billion downloads last week. So with this kind of expertise and talents, I'm only hoping that White Academy is going to be a huge success and help all our other business divisions as well.
Absolutely, Joe. Look, just remind me, you were looking initially to launch White Academy, what was it, in 2018? But you're looking to bring that forward and do it this year?
Yes, that's right. So sometimes there's this concept that startups always need more time to do things. Well, I believe that we need to do things as fast as possible. And when we have the right teams and the right ingredients in place, we can make this happen. So we just want to exceed the expectations.
You certainly are moving at quite a pace here. Are you excited about the next couple of months?
Yeah, I'm absolutely excited because I started the company 4.5 years ago. We went through all the product development process, fundraising, hiring unbelievable talent to our team, and getting through all the hurdles and also the IPO process, which was quite a milestone for us. But at this stage, when we are already starting to generate revenues from the research project in Manchester and now seeing the facility almost ready to start the research and to start processing stem cells, and seeing also that we are perhaps 1 month away of starting to generate revenues with CellPlan and bring this amazing solution to the market, I really couldn't be more excited, and the teams are burning the midnight oil to make it happen.
Always good to speak to you, Joao. Look, thanks very much for taking the time. Good to see you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Andrew. Have a great day.